18th birthday to Women of ALPFA. Thank you so much for joining us. I can tell you that we take great pride in bringing these types of events to our members. So thank you so much for taking the time and for joining us for this special event.
ALPFA focuses on women because 1 in 5 women in the U.S. are Latina. Projections are that by 2060, Latinas will form nearly 1/3 of the female population of this nation. The Women of ALPFA continues to pave the way and improve representation and earnings potential for our Latinas. ALPFA is proud to be part of this for a better, stronger future for America.
Somehow, some way, in some shape or form, we will make it happen. And, you know, we're no less of daughters, parents, you know, mothers, sisters, wives. We're no less leaders because of what all the things we have to play. And as I was reading the bios of our panelists, I was so impressed of how they too do it all. It's so nice to not be the only one and not be the first. We're surrounded by so many great leaders, and Latinas in particular, for today's theme.
For me, it's amazing to come to the Women of ALPFA event. I've actually been a member of ALPFA for over 20 years, and I was here to see the first Women of ALPFA event. It was really beautiful to really see how inspiring these women are as they progress in their own careers. And we have more role models today than we've ever had to really serve as an example for the women to come behind them.
Everyone wants to tell you about what's impossible, but no one wants to tell you about what's possible. Only you can drive yourself and tell you what's possible. So I really do subscribe to the old adage of where there's a will, there's a way. Because you have to have that drive and determination and make things happen for yourself. And so if I had listened to what everyone was telling me, I wouldn't be sitting before you here today.
You know, one of my favorite quotes is from former Secretary of State Madeleine Albright. I'm sure many of you have heard it already. There's a special place in hell for women who don't help other women. I don't want to go to hell, and I don't know anybody who wants to go to hell. So, you know, I have a lifelong passion to help other women. I mean, we must pay it forward, have that open door, be that ear, show those good listening skills, and share the successes and the failures, because we've all had them.
The best thing that the best compliment I would say that I received from the business unit CEO was, Marina, you were able to transform the culture of this organization. I can tell you, at that time, I thought it sounded good, but I didn't understand the meaning that it has and how powerful that phrase was. And I keep it now with me, and I know I can do it. And that I always refer to that phrase and those remarks, I mean, when I need to spike up.
Confidence comes from people. It doesn't come from just the work you do. I mean, you work hard. We all work hard. That's table stakes. That gets you in the door, because I think everyone around this room can say they work really hard. And just the fact that you're here proves that. But it's how you connect with people. And when you make those connections and they come up to you, and they tell you, I learned something that you said, or I appreciate this. I think that's where sort of my confidence came from.
Women of ALPFA, to me, is the opportunity of growth, to break the glass ceiling, because as a woman in finance, you're around a lot of men. So every time I come to a Women of ALPFA event, this is actually, I think, my third year, and it's just a little bit more of influence and a little bit more of a push to keep going and to just keep growing within the industry.